Hi, everybody. Welcome to the show. Hello, everyone. Welcome back to our channel. This is Raising A to Z, an inspirational and informational YouTube channel all about homeschooling. And my name is Amanda. I am a mom and a former teacher who homeschools my kids here in Northern Ontario. Today's video has been a heavily requested one. We've had multiple people comment on our videos, send us DMs, messages asking us to make this video. It is the What is Your Schedule video. Everyone wants to know, what does a typical homeschool day look like? What should I expect when it comes to scheduling? And so today that's what we're going to tackle. We're going to talk about, what does our homeschool schedule look like? And I want to make that clear that this is our schedule. This is what fits our family and our lives and our relatives that are nearby, and this is what works for us. And your homeschool schedule might look totally different, and that's okay. We're not comparing, we're not contrasting. Everyone has a different life and a unique family circumstance, and everyone's gonna have a different need and different types of things that they want in their homeschool schedule. So this is what works for us. I think a lot of you guys are gonna take it as kind of an idea of what you could be doing with your day or your time, and that's great. I'm glad that this could be helpful for you, but again, like, this is not the schedule that you must follow. Please make a schedule that works for your family. Another thing I need to say about our schedule, this schedule that I'm going to talk about today is kind of based off of what our schedule looked like last year, pre-pandemic. Some of these things might change depending on their availability with COVID. So depending on if our gymnastics classes are running, can we go into the library, things like that. Some of these things might change, but that's okay. We'll just roll with the flow, but at least this will give you kind of an idea of like what a typical homeschool day look like when it's not COVID. So before we get into this, I'm going to talk about what our workbook time looks like. I think it'll just make it easier to kind of go through the day without having to tell you all these things again and again. So when we sit down for workbook time, we do it like 2 to 3 times a week. Our workbook time is about 30 to 40 minutes, and we try to do 4 things when we do our workbook time. We try to do a little bit of math. We do a little bit of literacy workbook. So for Zoe right now, that's gonna be learning some letters. Alexi is learning letter sounds and small words. Then we go into journaling. So they will both each draw a picture in their journal, and then I will write out what they dictate to me, what the picture is. So Zoe will draw and dictate. Alexi will draw and dictate, and then I will highlight a couple words for her to copy and practice writing on herself. So yeah, we do math, literacy, journaling, and then we go into a read aloud. So the kids can pick any of the read alouds that we have in our, well, last year was a book basket. This year it is going to be some shelves that we have literally just put up. And those have all been kind of pulled out and selected to be books from our unit study for the month. So that is, when I say workbook time, those are the 4 things that we tackle every time we do workbook time. So now I'm gonna get into like what our week actually looks like. Monday morning, our kids wake up. They get up around between 7 and 7:30. Actually, that's a lie. They get up at 7 on the nose. And they go, they watch cartoons, they make some breakfast. And then typically Monday mornings, we go to Centre de Petit, which is a French preschool program run through our local French Catholic school board. It's a free program. It's supposed to be a feeder program into their school, so to introduce English kids to French language. But we don't plan on sending our kids, and we just use the program because it's free and it's fun. It's free lessons, free French lessons basically for our kids. And they don't mind. They don't mind. Like, they let Alexi come even though she's technically too old, and they have no problem with it. So that's typically what we do. We don't know if that's gonna run this year. If it doesn't run, I've actually already talked with a couple of homeschool families in our area, my sister-in-law and a friend, and we're gonna just kind of try to meet up at a park or something with a couple kids. So that's our plan for that section. Often we pick up the mail, do a little bit of cleaning when we come home, empty the dishwasher, that kind of stuff. We are pretty strict with lunch at noon. That's just what we like to do in terms of scheduling. I make lunch, they have lunch, and then at 1 o'clock we do a Bible story or devotion, and then we do quiet time. We do quiet time every single day. It is about an hour and a half-ish time where the girls have free access to either the unschool room or their bedroom, and it's all safe. We've everything secured. They have access to all kinds of toys and stuff, but it's all stuff that's safe for them to play with, unsupervised. And so they have the option of playing, coloring, doing a quiet activity, or going into their room and going for a nap. And we kind of leave that open for them. I think it's really good for them to have that time to decompress. It's really good for them to also like listen to their bodies. So if they're not feeling well or if they're just tired, we always tell them, listen to your body. Maybe you need to take a nap. Lexi's better than Zoe. Zoe really likes to go until she passes out. But Alexi will go and have a little nap every now and then. Zoe, sometimes we have to assist her in the napping section when she needs it, but it gives me a chance to go and have some time for me to decompress, to have like a cup of tea and, you know, maybe read a book or fold some laundry. I do a lot of our like planning during that time. If I need to order anything for like Alexi for her food allergies, that's kind of the chance when I get to do it, kind of when I need to do something completely uninterrupted, that is the time that I do it. So I highly recommend that you have a quiet time in your day, even if it's just half hour, 45 minutes. We do an hour and a half. My kids can handle it. They actually really enjoy it. But I even know people who have like 10, 11, 12 year olds, and they still do a quiet time where everyone has to go to a certain space and have a bit of a break. So it's a good thing to do when you are homeschooling, because it can be overwhelming to have kids with you all the time. So that's what we do. After quiet time, we have snack, and then we jump into a activity. So we do a unit study activity on Mondays after snack time. If you wanna learn how to build a unit study, we have a video for that. You can find that here. So I usually plan 4, sometimes 5 or 6 activities, at least 4, and we do at least 1 on Monday. And sometimes they take 10 minutes, sometimes they take an hour. And we just spend a little bit of time doing our unit study before the girls have like some free time again. Free time can be either indoors or outside. Stefan comes home, I'll make dinner. Mondays we are gonna try, this is something kind of newer this year, trying to have a little bit of a music lesson, especially for Alexi, to have a music lesson on Mondays. Stefan is a musician, very good musician, and so he's going to be giving Alexi like a 10 minute music lesson on a more regular basis, just because we really think that's important. So then we do bedtime routine around 8. Bedtime routine for us is the kids get a snack, pajamas, brush your teeth, and then we read a chapter out of a book. So that's part of our unit study. Each unit study we have a big book, and we read a chapter out of our big book. And then once the book is done, let's say there's only 20 chapters, there's obviously like 30 days in a month, give or take. And so after that, the kids can just pick a book until the next unit study starts up, so they can just pick whatever book they want off the shelf. So that's kind of how that's just a Monday. That's a typical Monday for us. On Tuesdays, we start the morning after breakfast with workbook time. And then usually we actually go visit Grammy. So we'll go visit my mom, who lives literally down the street. Sometimes she will just take the girls for an hour or two, and I'll come back home and do some chores or cleaning up or whatever, and then I'll go join them for lunch. Sometimes I'll stay and hang out. That's kind of just what we do. And then when we come home, we'll have a quiet time, followed by our snack, free time, then time for dinner. Once Stefan gets home, we have dinner. Tuesday night is bath night, and my kids are obsessed with baths. So our bath times are actually quite long, like 45 minutes to an hour is not unusual for my kids. So that takes a big section of time. And then again, we get into our bedtime routine, snack, brush your teeth, chapter book before bed. And that's our Tuesday. Yes, we have waffles on Wednesdays. We have waffles every Wednesday. A, it's fun alliteration, and the kids just think Waffle Wednesday is great. But also, waffles are something they eat fairly quickly in the morning. They kind of just gobble them right up, which is great because on Wednesdays we go to playgroup and it is about 45 minutes away. So it is a bit of a drive for us. We have to leave a little bit earlier. So the quicker they eat, the more likely we're gonna get to playgroup on time. So we go to a playgroup. Again, we're not sure what that's gonna look like this year, but we're gonna try to figure that out, and hopefully we can still be doing playgroup. After playgroup, we stop and pick up groceries just because we're in town, so we can actually get to like the bigger grocery stores that have more options for Alexi. So we'll go do a bit of a grocery run, and then I pack a lunch, and the girls just kind of have their packed lunch on as we're driving home, because like I said, it's about a 45 minute drive. So that works out really well for us. We come home, we have a small quiet time, usually about an hour on that day. We do a free time, and then again, it's dinner. We might go for a walk after dinner or something like that. And then it's bedtime. Wednesdays are kind of like We don't do a ton of like learning stuff, but it's a lot of like just living in errands and kind of just having a day to just have meet friends and socialize, which is really important for everybody, for us too. I love playgroup. It's actually a bit of a like mental break for me because I get to talk to other adults during the day, which is nice. So we love Wednesdays. What do we do on Thursdays? Thursday, we start our day with workbook time. It is our second workbook day of the week. Then we get into baking. So when we're done, we do a baking day for Alexi's food allergies and food sensitivities. If you want to know more about her eczema journey, you can check that out here. It is one of the reasons that we homeschool, is just her food sensitivities are crazy. So we actually end up having to do some baking pretty much every week. So we just work that into like, this is our homeschooling time. We read recipes and we, you know, measure and get all the ingredients and do all the baking. And so that's part of our homeschooling. And when we're done, they have free time until lunch. After lunch, we do quiet time, just like any other day. And then Thursdays has traditionally been our gymnastics night. So we, after quiet time, fairly soon after quiet time, we end up doing, having dinner early, going to gymnastics, and then going to the library because they're in the same building. And so the girls will have the class and then they go to the library. And that's when we'll pick up some new library books and just hang out. Again, we don't know if that will be able to happen this year, but typically that's what we would be doing. Then we come home, give the girls a shower, because that's much quicker than a bath for them. And then we get into our bedtime routine again of snack, brush your teeth, read a chapter of your book. Friday, we have two options for Friday. So depending on the day, here are two Friday options. So either it is an errand day or a home day. If it is an errand day, I try to schedule all the appointments that we need to do, or if you have any appointments, on a Friday morning. I've been known to book like the first slot of the day for doctor's appointments, eye doctor's appointments, chiropractor, like anything like that. I will be there first thing. I don't like waiting in medical offices. And because we live kind of farther out of town, it's a bit of a drive. I've been known to book an 8 a.m. slot, which means I have to be out of the door by 7:15. But it's just what works for us, and it kind of makes our day run smoothly when they're booked early. So I'll book important appointments. I will also, if I need any errands, if I have to pick up like a birthday present or anything like that, I will do that on like an errand day. And we'll go and run some errands. We might pick up lunch or I'll pack a lunch. And then we're usually home by like 1:30 in the afternoon. The girls will have a little bit of a quiet time. And when they wake up, we will do a poetry tea. And so we'll do poetry tea time instead of snack time. They're kind of the same, but there's poetry in it. So they like that. If you want more ideas on how to have poetry tea time, we'll put the link here for you guys, because that's always, it's a super easy and fun activity and my kids adore it. After tea time, we will just have, again, free time either outside or inside. And then I make dinner, and then Friday night is family night. So we'll either play some games or watch a movie and have snacks. Sometimes we do both depending on the day. And then it's bedtime. We don't always read a book at bedtime, especially if we watch the movie, because we let the kids stay up a little bit later. But that's kind of our typical errand day. If we're having a home day on a Friday, these happen like, yeah, errand days happen once, maybe twice a month. So we try to keep them to a minimum. Home days are a little bit different. So after breakfast, we will do workbook time again. Then we will do art exploration time. So every month I pick a different art medium to let them explore during art time. And so sometimes it's watercolor, sometimes it's paint, sometimes it's like, yeah, pastels, whatever we find, that's kind of a time. And I don't really do a lesson. I just let them have access to a new material. And it's often like, if it's a bigger, messier material, this is the time when I'll pull it out. So this is when we like get paints and glue and all the messy, messy things that we don't let them have often. This is when we pull it out. Whenever they're done with that, they can go and play, and we just kind of have like a really chill free time. And then we have lunch, quiet time. After quiet time, we'll do poetry tea. And then free time again, dinner, and then family night. So that's kind of our Monday through Friday. Saturday and Sunday, we basically devote to having like family time, going to church, hanging out, we clean out the house, we do a big cleanup on Saturday mornings. But it's just kind of our time to just hang out as a family because Stefan is home. We'll often have dinner with at least one set of grandparents since they both live like literally within 10 minutes of us. And so that is kind of our week. That's what we do. Every now and then we'll throw the day out and say, nope, we're doing something different. We'll go on a field trip or go to the science center, or, you know, we'll just say, forget it. We're all sick or having a movie day. Like, stuff happens, and we just kind of use this as like a rough outline so that we kind of, A, can kind of keep going in our homeschooling. We don't just sit around all day, but it also gives us something to do and like a purpose and like, okay, what are we doing today? Where are we going today? What's the plan for today? And so it's a, like you see, I don't use a lot of times. Basically, the only thing that's timed in our day is meals. So we have lunch at noon, we have dinner at 6, and we have bedtime snack starts at 8. Like, that's pretty much our only time things. It works for us. It keeps us motivated and excited and engaged. But we also, like I said, have the flexibility of like throwing it all out the window one day and just saying we want to do something totally different today. I hope this helped you guys with what a schedule can look like when you're homeschooling, what you guys want to be doing when you're homeschooling, how do you fill your day when you're homeschooling. It's a lot of fun. We enjoy it. I use the time blocking, well, mine's blank right now, but I will use the time blocking section in my planner to kind of keep things organized, and I update it a couple times a year because, you know, sometimes like our gymnastics night switches, like all of a sudden it's on a Tuesday instead of a Thursday, and or a different time or whatever. So like, we do like to put those things into a planner, into a calendar. It helps keep me organized, which I think is always very helpful. If you like this planner, this is the homeschool planner 2020 and 2021. This is a planner that we made, and I think it's a great resource for any homeschooler. It is available as a PDF download, which you can print yourself, or you can actually order it from Amazon and it comes all pre-bound and printed for you. So I hope this was helpful for you guys. I hope you enjoyed this video and that it kind of inspires you as to what a homeschool day can look like and how you can fill your time. If you guys ever have any ideas of videos you'd like to see or questions, please leave us a comment below or send us a DM on Instagram or Facebook. And make sure you subscribe and click the bell, and we'll see you guys next time. Thanks. Bye.